Hi, welcome to Community Hotline at Home. I'm your host, Monica Weitzel. Today we'll be talking with the Nonprofit Association of Oregon, or NAO. NAO is a statewide nonprofit membership organization serving Oregon's public benefit nonprofits by strengthening their collective voice to enrich all of our lives. Oregon's nonprofits work in every community, and during the COVID-19 crisis, NAO has been bringing late-breaking news and information to Oregon nonprofits and their supporters. Now is the time to continue to support Oregon's nonprofits more than ever, and we'll find out why. With us today is Lalisa Hall, Director of Membership, Communications, and Advancement at the Nonprofit Association of Oregon. Welcome, Lalisa.
Thank you, Monica. Thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure to have you here. First of all, can you tell us what has been the most difficult thing for local nonprofits to navigate in these last few months of the COVID-19 crisis, and how the NAO has been able to help?
Yeah, for nonprofits, it has been a trying and tremendous time serving our communities. As you know, nonprofits touch practically every facet of our lives here in Oregon, in our communities, and across the country in general. And so for us, it's been, how do we focus on serving our communities, whether it's food and shelter, education, at-risk kids, the environment, arts and culture? All of those things, we have been wanting to make sure that we continue to move forward on those things, but it has been difficult. And in a lot of cases, nonprofits have not been able to do what they usually do, particularly the arts and culture organizations. And so for nonprofits across the board, it has been trying from both a service perspective as well as from an internal perspective.
Right, right. So how do we continue to serve the people that need us, yet continue to survive as a nonprofit organization?
Correct. And so from NAO's perspective, what we have been doing is providing resources to nonprofits. From an infrastructure standpoint, there's legal, there's human resources issues, insurance issues that nonprofits have been grappling with. And so our role is to make sure that we're providing the resources to them and bringing in experts who can help them navigate those challenges.
Right. I've virtually been to a few of the webinars that the NAO has put on, and they've been really helpful to understand what we can do, what resources are available to us, how we can, as a nonprofit, can survive in the community yet still provide our services. So that's been a great help. What are some of the other things that you've been able to do?
So we have been doing a lot of online sessions. As you know, we have in-person, or had, I should say, prior to COVID-19, had a lot of in-person sessions. We do equity and inclusion networks. We do fiscal managers networks, all of those things to help bring professional development and volunteer development to organizations. We have pivoted and are bringing a lot of those resources online specific to COVID-19 and how to create solutions for the challenges that we're facing. So we've been doing a lot of those things. We also have, so we bring subject matter experts in to mm-hmm. help nonprofits. We also have been doing some town hall sessions.
Lalisa, how has the fundraising and ability to earn income for nonprofits, how has that been impacted by COVID-19?
It has been impacted, Monica, in a pretty big way, a substantial way. As you know, fundraising season generally happens 2 times a year, usually in the spring and the fall. COVID hit just as major fundraisers were, teeing off. Many of them have been pivoting to virtual fundraisers, and hats off to them. So that's sort of one of the major ways. Other ways in which nonprofits are hurting is a lot of the contracts that they have with governments, so are down, could potentially be impacted, you know, as we go into the rest of the year. A lot of nonprofits do government work, support the public sector. Corporations are tightening their belts. And I will say that many corporations, though, are continuing to support nonprofits. But there are some who, you know, for obvious reasons have had to tighten their belts as well. So there are some major challenges that, that nonprofits are facing, and individuals as well. As you can imagine, there has been, you know, rampant unemployment as well. So, so nonprofits are hurting overall, but I would say that if folks can give to nonprofits and can volunteer, please, please do that to support nonprofits across the state who are supporting our communities.
That's right. I think sometimes people don't think about how we have to survive as nonprofits as well. And we can't help everyone else if we don't have our funding. So one of the things you mentioned also was the DEI work, the digital equity and inclusion work that you're doing. And, you know, there have been times lately where that has been at the top of people's minds. And there's a lot of nonprofits doing work in that area right now, which is so important to look at everything we do through that DEI lens. So I've found online your Equity and Inclusion Lens Guide, which is really great. It's a really good resource for nonprofits to be able to sort of navigate their way through that whole process. And I would encourage any nonprofits who are watching to be sure to check that out.
NAO has been doing a diversity, equity, inclusion work for more than 30 years. We have an equity inclusion network that we have here in the Portland metro area. And the diversity, equity, inclusion lens guide that you mentioned is on our website. You're absolutely right. We published it last year, and we've made it available to everyone and anyone who is interested in using it. And we encourage folks to do that. And we don't expect that it's absolutely the right guide for everyone, but I'm sure that folks will be able to take some of the information in that guide and operationalize it in their own organizations. So we're very, very excited about that and hope that as many people as possible, you know, take a look at it.
The other thing that I recently stumbled upon, and I think this is even newer, is your NAO portal, your learning portal. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Absolutely. We just launched that portal, and it is a partnership with Nonprofit Ready. So it's an NAO Nonprofit Ready portal. And for our members, we are curating resources. As you know, there's tons of resources out there. And so our role is to help nonprofits navigate the resources. And so we have curated resources as well as developed some of our own. And nonprofit members can access that portal, and it has information about board governance, leadership development, financial information, financial management, all kinds of tools, whether it's checklists, FAQs, learning modules, all kinds of, that can help you figure out, you know, if you're looking for a resource, you go right there and you could Google it and just sort of search for, you know, what might be the most effective for your organization.
Right. I'm very excited to use it because there's just so much there. So, is there anything going on in the future that we should know about with NAO, or anything in particular you really want people to know about the work that you're doing in the community?
Sure. Thanks for that question, Monica. So as you know, for those of you who don't know, Nonprofit Association of Oregon is the statewide association for the nonprofit sector. So we're a membership model, and we have nonprofits who are members. So thank you all for being members, and you all are members as well. So thank you for that.
Yes.
And we also have members who are supportive of the nonprofit sector and who provide products and services. So a lot of the businesses who focus on corporate social responsibility, who support work. So whether it's financial organizations or legal organizations who partner with nonprofits, as well as government entities and funders. So wanted to make sure people were aware of who we who we are. And also, I think there are some key data points that people may want to know a little more about. There are about 22,000 nonprofits in the state of Oregon. That, when I say 22,000, that's charitable nonprofits, 501c3 organizations like NAO.
Right.
We make up about 200,000 employees across the state. This is before COVID-19, so it'll be interesting to see where that goes, and then $10 billion in payroll.
That's a huge, it's a huge business, really. It's a huge business.
That is. And you know, nonprofits are corporations. We have a business to run. And our business is to support communities to make sure they thrive and have, you know, we're, you know, that communities are vital to the success of Oregon. So that's sort of who we are. We do public policy and advocacy work. We do a lot of research and thought leadership and provide resources. And whether it's resources to figure out how to be more effective in your internal organization, as well as focusing on volunteer development and convening. So those are all the things that we do to support nonprofits in Oregon.
That's a huge help. I always say that it doesn't matter who you are, everyone is touched by a nonprofit. You know, whether
Absolutely.
You volunteer for one, you're helped by one, you attend an arts event that is, you know, put on by a nonprofit. I mean, they touch every aspect of society. And so that's why it's so important, I think, for us to support the local nonprofits, especially at this time. So if people, you know, have a little money to give, you know, this is a good place to put your money. And if it's and if you're already giving, then maybe you can ramp it up a little bit.
Oregonians volunteer in a big way. And we're number three in the nation. That's amazing. 43% of Oregonians volunteer with a nonprofit organization. That is amazing. And so to your point, you know, we would love to, you know, encourage you all to support nonprofits, to volunteer, whether it's, you know, time, talent, and treasure. And we really appreciate Oregonians and the work they do to help nonprofits, you know, help Oregon thrive.
It makes me proud to hear that. So thank you so much, Lalisa, for what you're doing at the Nonprofit Association of Oregon. And keep up the good work. We'll be seeing you around.
Well, thank you. Thanks for having us, and appreciate it.
You're welcome. You. From all of us at Metro East, please be safe and stay healthy.
Oregonians care. We give. We volunteer. It's who we are. Nearly 20,000 charitable nonprofits across the state rely on our generosity to help communities thrive. And now, more than ever, Oregon nonprofits need our support. It starts with a spark of goodness from people like you. It's not about recognition or even a tax deduction. We give because we care. It's who we are. Care like an Oregonian. Give to local nonprofits.